Today, I show you my fully modded Marlin 5. What is up, guys, and welcome back to another video. I've had a lot of requests for this video, and today I'm gonna show everybody my fully modded Trek Marlin 5. This is my Trek. A little story of how this thing came about. Two of my buddies, Nick and Jeremy, they got me this bike as a wedding present. It is a 2020 Trek Marlin 5. I rode it a little bit, stock how it was, and realized there's a couple things that I wanted to change out. So I changed a couple things, the forks, pedals, grips, stuff like that. And then as I started getting more into the actual biking, I changed out a whole lot more stuff. And now the only thing that is factory on this bike is the frame. So we might as well start from the top. So we'll start with the handlebars. These handlebars are Wake 780 mil bars. They're blue. I think I'm gonna actually buy new ones that are black because I don't like the blue, but doesn't really match. And then moving on, I have ODI grips that are actually really nice. The only thing I miss, this bike came with like paddled grips where they had a little bit of a stop on them on the outsides. Those were really nice for climbing, for other things like that. I'm finding that my hands start to hurt after going downhills a little bit, maybe sometimes uphills on flats, stuff like that, but you get over it. Next, I have a Fun Crossfire 50 millimeter stem. This was a immediately noticeable upgrade. It moved the handlebars closer to me, in return, getting a lot more control of the bike, along with the handlebars being wider helped also. Then the front brake, it's a Shimano. I have a rear brake for it as well. I just haven't installed it yet. But my rear brake goes directly to the handlebar, so that's not a good thing. Then I have my dropper post lever up top as well. So now to the front of the bike, I have a RockShox Judy Silver, 100 mil travel, 32 millimeter stanchions. It has lockout. I'm not sure if it's able to have a remote to do remote lockout, but I don't mind letting go of the handlebar and turning it myself. I don't really need it. I run a lot higher pressures than it has for my weight because I jump. So that's a really nice thing to have for climbing, but I don't see myself using it often. I never really use it. Sometimes I will if I'm on the road, but that's about it. Now onto the wheels and tires. I have a set of Stans No Tubes Crest Mark III with speed tuned hubs, front and rear. And wrapped around them is a Maxxis Minion DHF and DHR. 29.26 in the front and 29.23 in the rear. I wish I could fit a 2.6 in the rear, but you just can't. It says the biggest you could fit in the rear is a 2.0, but that's false. I have a 2.3. The rear, this is probably the biggest that I will fit in the rear because maybe you can go to a 2.4, but I wouldn't try it for myself because I'm happy with how these perform. But I think what I'm going to do is get another DHF when this rear one wears out and run it on the rear too. Back up to the front, I have a Mucky Nuts fender because you don't want your nuts to get mucky. On the down tube, I have a little bike pump, and on the seat tube, I have a bottle holder that I never use. My dropper post is a KS E10R. It is externally routed because this model does not have the hole in the seat tube for the dropper post cable to go up. I'm pretty rough on a bicycle, so I don't want to have to drill a hole and then something happens to the frame and I have to get it warrantied, and then they don't warranty it because I drilled a hole. So I just got an external routed dropper post and I have to deal with an extra cable up front. Big whoop. The seat is a fabric. I got it because it's got really nice reviews and it matches the bike kind of. So on to the drivetrain. This is a SRAM NX Eagle 1x12 and I added a 32 tooth oval chainring to it. That's partially the reason why I got these new wheels, because I needed an XD driver in the rear. My factory wheel didn't have that, so now I have that and it'll fit it. So then it has SRAM NX Eagle cranks. I have Bontrager pedals on it. Your little flashlight. This bike does come with hydraulic brakes front and rear, which at that price point is pretty uncommon. And then I just have a Lizard Skins chainstay protector just to stop the chain slap noise and other little things like that. But yes, this bike performs fantastic now. Going up hills with the old setup wasn't ideal. It was a 3x7 drivetrain, and I tell you what, it was a pain in the ass to go up some steep hills. Everybody else had 1x12s and they are just blazing away. Like, I'm finding myself, I don't have to even be in first gear sometimes to climb the hills that I was struggling with the old setup. Now, all of these modifications do not make me a better rider. That comes with practice. I built this bike the way I did because that's what I wanted. That's what I wanted to do. I didn't put bigger tires and a 1x12 thinking that it would make me a better rider. It's not how it works. And then to end off the modifications, I have 180 millimeter rotors front and rear. And you really notice that. There's a couple times that I've had to panic stop and I went right over the handlebars by pulling the front brake. So try and use your back brakes, kids. All right, so I'm gonna do a couple runs around the yard, do some little drops, if you will, see how this bike performs. Well, I hope you liked the mod list that I did to my bike. I certainly love my bike. I ride it as much as I can. And I still can't thank Nick and Jeremy enough for getting me this as a wedding present. That is it for me today. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time.